Hi, I'm Carly McAvoy. I want to talk about fractions, mixed numbers versus improper notation. Sometimes we're given a mixed number and we want to state our answer as an improper fraction. And here's the steps to do that. Here's a mixed number. It's got a whole number part in a proper fraction part. We're going to multiply the whole number by the denominator and then add the numerator. That's going to become our new numerator. So 5 times 4 is 20. Plus 3 is 23. And then the denominator stays the same. So we have 4. Why do I say the sum? Because we have 5 times 4, then plus 3. And the sum is an answer to an addition problem. So after you add those two things together, that's what goes over the original denominator. The next one, 3 times 12 is 36, plus 11 is 47 all over the original denominator, which is 12. It's okay if you want to use a calculator to do 3 times 12 plus 11, that'd be totally fine. But you should know the process even without a calculator. You might want to pause the video and try these three problems. It's always good to try these on your own before you just watch somebody else do them. But here's what I'm going to do. 1 times 50 is 50. Plus 7 is 57, and that's going to be over 50. In the second one, 2 times 9 is 18, plus 8 is 26, and that goes over the original denominator of 9. 5 times 10 is 50, plus 1 is 51 over 5. So that's changing a mixed number to an improper. Sometimes we want to go the other way. We have an improper and we have need of a mixed number. So here's the steps for that. That is, divide the numerator by the denominator. This is a little more confusing to hear. It's not so bad when you're actually doing it. The quotient becomes the whole number, and the remainder is the new numerator. And as always, the denominator stays the same. So what do I mean by that? If I take 17 and divide by 3, that is the numerator divided by the denominator. 3 goes into 17 5 times, and I have a remainder of 2. This number, the quotient 5, that is the whole number. The remainder 2 is the new numerator, and the denominator that we started off with stays the same. So I get 5 2/3. You can reverse that to check it. 3 times 5 is 15, plus 2 is 17. That's correct, right? Okay, how many times does 8 go into 9? It goes one time with how many left over? 1. And then the denominator stays the same. You can always do it off to the side if you need to see the quotient and the remainder. And then 7 goes into 7 one time. And here's an example when we tried to change it to a mixed number, but it actually came out to be a whole number, which is totally fine. If we can get a whole number, we like to work with those. So that's totally fine if there's no remainder left over. Okay, again, maybe try these three by yourself. Pause the video and then come back and see how you did. 7 goes into 18 twice with 4 left over. 11 goes into 25 twice with 3 left over. Notice the denominator always is the same. 25 goes into 77 3 times with 2 left over. And again, you don't have to be able to do that math on your own. You can use your calculator to help you through the calculations. Note that proper fractions cannot be changed into mixed numbers because all proper fractions have a value that are less than 1. I think I should say are there, but anyways, so if I have something like I had above, 7 over 7, where they match exactly, that's one whole. That means anything less than that is less than 1. These are all things that are less than 1, and it should be obvious to you that as we get smaller on the top, our fractions get smaller. So that 7 sevenths is the greatest number here, then it goes down this way so that 1 seventh is the least of these, right? So anytime you have a number on the top that's smaller than the denominator, that's a proper fraction, and it's less than 1. All right, have a great day.